Welcome to video number 4 of your database clustering series. This is Caleb from Caleb the Video Maker 2. I got a lot of good useful information in this video, so I'm hoping it's helpful for you guys. Let's get started. So in the previous video, we talked briefly about Galera. And Galera is an example of a database clustering technology. And this technology basically just describes, the infrastructure and also some other things. So this is a master-master infrastructure, or topology, I should say. And what that means is that all of your nodes are in equal standing. You can write data to all of the nodes, and you can read data from all of the nodes. So if you have multiple nodes, obviously data is going to have to be transferred somehow. Because, you know, we write to this node, well, how exactly does that get replicated to these nodes? And when does that happen? Well, there's two real categories of how that happens. And that is synchronous versus asynchronous. Probably gonna spell this wrong, but I don't know. And also asynchronous. Let's talk about asynchronous first. The way asynchronous data transfer works is it just happens sometime in the future. You're not really sure when it happens, you just know that it will happen. So I write to this node first, and then eventually that data will be replicated down to the nodes. But we're not guaranteed, you know, hey, this is gonna take 20 seconds or 5 minutes. It's just gonna happen sometime. Now, I think some databases give you the capability to kind of determine the time frame of within how long you want that to happen, but I don't think you are going to always have that capability. So essentially, when you're working with asynchronous transfer, you cannot always be guaranteed that these nodes, the ones that are getting replicated to, are up to date. And that's a term called slave lag. And it's kind of weird because we're in a master-master topology here, but Galera actually is synchronous, which is a little different. So if we're using an asynchronous system, we're probably in a master-slave system where the data gets replicated from the master down to the slaves, and that time difference is called slave lag. So for example, if you write to this master and then immediately read from the slave, that data might not actually have propagated yet down to the slave, and you might be getting not up-to-date data. So that's why I like synchronous. And what that means is the data is transferred immediately. As soon as you make the change here, it's going to propagate to all of the nodes. Galera has a pretty cool system where all of the nodes have to be in mutual agreement that the data can be written, and all of the data is going to be applied immediately. It's kind of confusing how Galera works on this, and I kind of get it, but not entirely sure I get all of it, to be honest. But essentially, you make a change, and this node will propagate that change down to the other nodes. And let's say this node says, oh yeah, that's okay. Well, it's going to keep those changes on that node, and then this one says it's okay. And once they're all in agreement, then you're good. But if for any reason one of these says, oh no, we can't apply that for some reason, well then all of those changes are going to be rolled back and that data is not going to be inserted into the database. Yeah, I probably totally just slaughtered the way it works, but that's my Caleb Curry explanation, aka incorrect. I think it was close enough though. The downside with synchronous though is that the writing process altogether kind of takes longer because we have to get agreement amongst all these things before the official change is applied. That means when we're writing to our database, that transaction is going to take longer. Whereas with a master-slave topology, you can just write to the master, boom, it's done, and then that data change gets applied everywhere. So it's kind of a give and take. It just depends on what you're working with and your situation, whether you would like synchronous or asynchronous. That is all, everyone. That gives you the rundown of synchronous and asynchronous technologies for transferring data and how that works. And these terms are pretty universal in programming, so if you haven't heard these terms, you'll definitely want to memorize these because this is a very common thing to describe how things happen. If something happens sometime in the future, it's asynchronous. If it happens right away and we actually have to wait for it to finish, it's synchronous. And they're both good things. It just depends on the situation. So if you found this video helpful, please be sure to click subscribe And, you know, share this video with your friends. Let me know what you suggest, if there's anything I left out or if anything could be explained in a better way. Please leave that in the comments below, because I look at those and that helps me make better content. So thanks, guys, and I will see you in the next video.